Hi, I'm Alan White. I'm a teacher here at the International Christian Institute. And you're watching this. I assume you're watching this because you're a student here at ICI. And we're getting ready to start a new semester, a new year, a new school year. And if you've been here before, you know how things go. You know what we do during the week, what our schedule is normally. If you haven't been a student here before, I'd like to tell you that, as we say, it's in our name that we are a Christian school. And so, because it's part of who we are, and because that's what God wants us to do, we believe, we have a time every week, a devotional time, in which we read from God's Word, and we pray to God, we talk about God, and about us, about you and me, and our relationship with God, and so on. And we learn as much as we can, or we try to, as much as we can, so that our faith will increase, or we'll get faith in God, and that our faith will increase, and we will know what God wants, how we can worship Him, how we can please Him, how we can serve Him, how to live our life according to God's will. And so we do this, we have this time once a week in which we do that every Wednesday morning. You'll be watching a videotape, usually of me. Maybe there will be someone else who might speak to you sometime. But there will be a time when you will watch on your TV screen a video, and we'll share God's Word, and we'll talk about God's Word, and we'll talk about what does that mean for you and for me. And we'll probably 20 minutes, the video will be about 20 minutes long, and then you'll have an opportunity to discuss that, maybe to answer some questions on a piece of paper. You'll have the passages, the text, or the words from God's Word in front of you. I usually copy them out and print them out, one for each student, and it's taken straight from the Bible. I don't change it. So what you have in your hand is the actual words that God gave to us through His prophets and through His writers and through Jesus. And so that's what we study, and that's what we talk about. And so what we will be learning about during the semester, the way this normally goes, is we first talk about who God is so that we can learn as much as we can about Him, because that's what God wants. He does want us to know about Him. And we will learn about the various characteristics of the things about God, and so that we can know Him in a very personal way. And you say, well, how can you know God personally? Well, we're going to talk about that. And you would say, maybe you ask, why would God want us to know Him personally, since He's God and we're not? We'll talk about that as well. And then we'll learn about us, about why God made us, who we are, and God's purpose according to God's will, God's plan for His world. Where do we fit in that? And why is there so much suffering and pain and sorrow and so many bad things in the world around us? What does that have to do with me and God? What does that have to do with God's relationship to people, to you and to me? And so we're going to talk about a lot of that as well. And so I hope at the end of this semester, you'll have a better understanding of all of those things. You'll learn about Jesus, because we are a Christian school, and we're not ashamed of who we are and what we believe and who we believe in. But if you're curious, would you like to know who Jesus is, and how does He fit into all of this? Hopefully I will explain that to you. I'll read that to you out of the Bible, out of God's own words, who Jesus is and why he came and what he did for you and what he did for me and so on. So that's part of it as well. And so at the end of the semester, I hope you have a much better understanding of all of that. And I hope that you will, as I said in the beginning, that your faith will be born if you don't have faith in God, and that faith that you do have will increase, will, we say, deepen, will get stronger or deeper or bigger, whatever word you would like to use there, in understanding and in confidence and in... There's many things that you'll gain from this, like a feeling of hope, of peace, of purpose. Like, why, God, why did you make me? What is my purpose here on the earth? There's a lot you're going to learn about that here. And so God does offer. He offers meaning to us. He offers hope to us. He offers peace to us. I was going to read one little passage for you here, because it does say in the New Testament that Jesus himself came and preached peace to you who were far away and peace to those who were near. And you say, well, far away. Well, you are foreign students. You came from all over the world to come here. You were far away. Now you're here. And so Jesus, in the place that he was teaching, he was in the Middle East, and he was talking to people who were far away from him or from where he lived and where he preached and so on, and to people who were near, his own people. And so that includes all of us. That's the poor purpose. You're foreign students. You came from a long ways away to come here to this country. And so God offers peace to you from wherever you come from. And God offers peace to those of us who were born and raised in this country. He offers peace to all of us if we want it, if we ask for it, if we accept it, if we believe it, and if we live according to what he wants of us. So that's what we're going to do. This is just a little introduction to the semester. We're not going to do the normal thing that we'd normally do. I just want you to know that this is what you can expect every Wednesday morning or every Wednesday afternoon, depending on which class you're in. You'll be starting with this, I hope, and you can count on it. You can look forward to it, I hope, every week, that we will be talking about these things. Now, you're going to be learning English from it. You've just listened to me in English, and I hope most of you understood everything that I said. And so I'm going to talk about words and the meanings of those words and so on, and something about the English. And you're going to practice listening to me and trying to understand what I'm saying and what God is saying through me, I hope. So you're going to learn English along with things about God. And I hope you're excited about that. I hope you're interested in it. I am. I'm interested in telling you, and I'm excited about sharing this book with you, God's words with you, the things of God with you. So, welcome again to the school and to the semester. I hope you have a great semester. I hope God blesses you richly in everything that you are doing here in your life. And I'm going to pray that right now. If you'll pray with me, that's what we always do at the end of these devotions, we pray. So please pray with me now. God, you are good, you are great, you are wonderful, you are worthy of our praise and our honor. You will bring glory to yourself through all things, through us and through our lives. And so God, we pray that you will use this school, that you will use me, that you will use the teachers of this school to bring you glory, to bring you honor, to praise you, to lift you up and make your name great, and to increase the knowledge of you throughout the world so that people will come to you and know you and believe in you and have hope and have peace and have purpose, a real purpose in their lives because of that. So God, I pray your blessing upon the students. I pray your blessing upon this school. I pray your blessing upon the teachers here. Lord, I pray that you would bless our lives, our families, the children that we have in our families in this country, as well as all of the families represented here back home, the mothers and fathers and sisters and brothers who are back in the countries where our students came from. I pray you'd bless them. And God, it is for you that we exist. It's for you that the school exists. It's for you that we do these things. And I just pray, Father, that it is exactly what you want us to do. It's according to your will and according to your purpose. And that it accomplishes everything you want to accomplish. And so I pray all of these things in the name of Jesus, our Lord and Savior. Amen. Thank you.